Bro, it's rolling. Hey, you. Huh?
You sure?
Yeah.
Hey, get up. I've been in the spirit reading. Give me John 15. John 15. This is something that's been on my mind all week.
Besides the demons, goblins, and goblins.
Besides, yeah, the demons were out last night, boy.
Yes, they were.
It was even on the Drudge Report, even the, well, you know, the Catholic Church, they're full of shit. But they said with Halloween this year, the demons were in, there was more demons this year than any other year before.
Wow.
Man, but it's the Catholic Church is the one who perpetrated that goddamn holiday. Now they complaining about it. That don't make no damn sense. Because Halloween used to be called All Hallows Eve. Because remember what, November 1st is the All Saints Day, you know what I'm saying, something like that, right? So All Hallows Eve was the day before. And so the reason everyone's celebrating Halloween, worshiping Satan, is because of the Catholic Church. They're the ones who perpetrated that bullshit.
Yeah, they sanctioned that shit.
They'll have Halloween parties in the fucking church, dress up like devils. That makes perfect sense.
They sure do.
Let me get
Church
one.
Church of High Street was pumping as usual.
Let me get one scripture real quick.
Freak fest. Everything was going on.
Thanks.
That's in John 15.
Got to be a freak fest, man.
Start at 15 and alright.
These people ain't gonna shun all these any of these holidays.
We get there.
And any of this wicked ass pagan shit, man, till the Lord bring his wrath down on him, man. So obviously, he's gonna just have to do it. Because these people ain't gonna change their motherfucking ways.
You can tell people that Halloween and Christmas is pagan till you blew in the face. And they'll forget that you told them that, and it doesn't even register. You're just wasting your time talking to most of these fools, man.
Right.
But we're gonna mark them anyway.
That child is too little, grown ass, teenagers going around.
They're gonna get candy. When you gonna go get some sperm candy? I don't let my children go trick-or-treating because you don't look all these homosexuals. There's homosexuals everywhere you look. What do you think the homosexuals ditch your children's candy on Halloween? Oh. They jacked off on it. Put it up their ass, pissed on it. They probably let it marinate and piss overnight.
You saw up in Reynoldsburg, they found a razor blade in somebody's snicker bar.
There you go. Eat some razor blade candy. Oh, that's loving the children.
This is Amos 5 and 21. I despise your feast days, and I will not smell in your solemn assemblies.
That's straight and to the point of feast days. And Halloween is a feast of candy. You gonna give your children, oh, say the candy doesn't have sperm or razor blades in it. It's still a bunch of sugar that's gonna rot out their teeth. But all these kids walking around, taking part. Yeah, they're kids too. A kid is a baby goat, something to be sacrificed. So when your children go out trick-or-treating, it's symbolically, you're symbolically sacrificing them to the devil.
That's why they call them kids.
Yeah, that's why they call them kids. Because that's a baby goat.
So that shit on movies. Like Michael Myers. I never know Michael Myers like all that.
Yeah, well, they said Michael Myers was possessed by the spirit of Sam Hain. And Sam Wayne, I forget how you say it. People always say I'm saying it wrong. Who gives a fuck? It's some heathen shit. We ain't with it. Yeah, no, it's fine. We get whatever we get in the spirit with now. We in the spirit.
First Thessalonians 5:22. Abstain from all appearance of evil.
You dress up too, like a goddamn grown fool. You know, a grown fool.
Hey, they be dressing up with some gay shit too. People dressing up in drag, men dress up like women. That's a faggot. You got women who dress their little boys up as girls. Mom did that. They didn't do it to me. They did it to my brothers. Fucking. That's just some fucking weirdo shit, man.
Hey, while World War III is brewing tremendously, everybody over here being clowns, man.
Being clowns.
Being clowns. U.S. Special Forces and enter into Syria, which I'm sure they already been there anyway.
Oh, they've been there.
But it's out publicly now, you know?
Yeah, the U.S. is fighting a proxy war against the Russians. And even in the British said that they've been given free rein to shoot down Russian fighter jets. So now you got the British fighting the Russians too, with the United States.
Bring it on.
And China's right there with them.
There's still Halloween celebrations going on. This ain't what I'm talking about anymore, man. It's still going on, man.
Yeah, because now Halloween is like a whole month now. It's the whole,
right.
the whole season is Halloween. Now you got goddamn Thanksgiving coming around the motherfucking corner.
Right.
One after another. Pow,
damn,
pow,
that
pow,
shit
pow,
don't
pow,
fucking
pow,
end.
Pow, man. They just don't stop, man. Here, Proverbs 1. Did you discuss something?
I actually do got some, but not yet.
Proverbs 1 and 22. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity and scorners delight in their scorning and fools hate knowledge?
Yeah, these fools hate knowledge. Like we say every time we try to teach them about the holidays, about the origins, they just don't even care. They just don't care at all. It's like factual information does not matter.
Man, they sitting back hoping and praying these prophecies don't come true, man.
Yeah, right.
Well, that's why we don't get challenged out here as much no more, because they see shit happening. And they hoping and praying, man. Them fools out, them bums out of the street that's reading them Bible fools. I pray they wrong, man. I pray.
He told me,
Jesus.
He told me y'all seen Leonard.
Yeah, we seen Leonard last week. I wish we would have got it on. We didn't get it on camera. The camera already died.
Yeah, we got a little treat though, because you know we stopped and we kept pushing the word without the camera. So we got rewarded with Leonard and that demon, you know.
Oh, we had another demon. Yeah. I forget who he was talking about.
Yeah, that was a terror.
That's right. The weird
the
Esteban.
Yeah, right.
Yeah,
right.
He was bugged out of his goddamn mind.
Oh, God. The more we was with him, the worse he started acting, man.
Then he just started freaking out.
right. But Leonard was the real treat.
Man, Leonard
was the treat.
He looks full-on schizo. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's full-on just bugged out of his goddamn mind.
His face was the witness, man.
Because the last time we seen him, we was cool talking, shooting shit.
Kicking for hours.
Yeah, kicking it for hours, right?
Yeah. Like, every time we seen him, it was like that.
Like, this is my dude Leonard. We kicking it with him. And now Leonard's bugged out of his goddamn mind. We told him what was gonna happen.
He stopped right
that's
behind the pole and was looking at us.
Man, like for years.
Oh yeah.
I told him that, like, that's crazy.
Yeah, first he was standing right over there and he was peeping us.
Like
and
this.
Then somebody said, there go Leonard. And I was like, get your ass over here, boy. And he came over here.
But he came, it was crazy.
He was scared of us. He said he had beardophobia. He was afraid of beards.
Damn.
You should have saw his face, man.
He was bugged out. Leonard's out of there.
Yeah, he's out of there.
Shit, he might not even, after that night, he might have committed suicide
jumped
or something.
Jumped off one of them buses.
Jumped off a cliff or something.
Damn.
Yeah, brother, cool or not, man, most I get your ass.
Cause, yeah, people understand, we're like people to come around us and we give them the truth.
We've seen it before, though.
It's like everywhere we walk, everything around us just dies. You know what I'm saying?
Who is that? What character is that?
There's some character, yeah, character. That everything he touches, it dies.
Right. Damn.
Yeah, there was somebody like that. I forget.
Rogue?
Yeah, Rogue. Well, she'd take your power.
Yeah, suck your life.
Yeah, suck the life and put you in a coma.
A succubus.
Yeah, that's a succubus.
Yeah,
she would look good,
that's
too.
Weird. She's a female, too.
Yep. That was Gambit's girl. Yeah, because if you reject the truth of the Most High will just kill you. He'll slowly erode your mind.
That's the worst.
Yeah, fuck with your mind. We can tell you countless people to drop dead after we try to give them the truth. I can't even remember them all. There's so many of them. We try to go through the list before. People that actually drop dead. But there's a bunch of them. We don't witness all kind of people dropping dead around us after we give them the truth. If they don't drop dead, they get locked up or
bad things happen.
Bad things, they get bugged out in their mind, they go crazy.
Bad things.
I think it's funny.
They don't understand the they don't know the Lord. That's his truth.
Hey, let me read this. Malachi 2:1. And now, O ye priests, this commandment is for you. Talking that, you know, all these. Well, this is originally talking to the priests of Israel. But nowadays, it's going to apply to the priests in the churches, leading our people astray. You know, the Catholic priests. Starting with the Catholic, they're the top ones, right? Because pretty much all these Baptist church Methodists, they're all Catholic, all right? Everything starts with the Roman Catholic Church, and it trickles on down from there.
Yeah, it just starts on wicked-ass Israelite niggas.
How you say it? Catholic.
Apostolic succession.
Apostolic succession.
Yeah.
Actually, if there was one of those, that would be actually in reality be us. Coming from the apostles is not the Catholic Church. They don't come from the apostles. They come from Satan. It's like you do Peraza. I always suspected he was a closet Catholic. Mm-hmm. With all them Trinity things he be doing. Give you the hug 3 times. He'll come up and do a 1, 2, 3. Every time, 3. Going back to that Trinity, doing the... Yeah, he'll do this now 3 times. 1, 2, 3.
Wow.
That's that Catholic shit, man.
Sure the fuck is. He's just using the Lord's name as a cloak.
Yeah, as a cloak. You can't hide. You know what I mean? That's what you call taking the Lord's name in vain. And you don't want to do that. What about them other dudes like Zabak? Then we got next fools. They that shit even still around?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. That shit is weak. But they all wear them flair delises, them little the Catholic flowers. You know, like the New Orleans Saints. You know the New Orleans Saints symbol? That's the flair delise. That's a Catholic symbol. And you got motherfuckers that call themselves Israelites wearing that all over their garments.
That's crazy.
That's bugged out. I mean, what kind of bugged out shit is that? All right, let me read the rest of this real quick. And now, O ye priests, this commandment is for you. If ye will not hear, and if ye will not lay it to heart to give glory unto my name, saith the Lord of hosts, I will even send a curse upon you. So, if you don't give glory to the name of Yahweh, the Lord is going to bring a curse upon you. Because you got people saying the Lord's name don't matter. So they gonna get cursed like that Nathaniel dude.
Not in Christ.
Yeah, it didn't say Christ. It said, when you look this in Hebrew, it says, Lord is Yahweh. Okay, that's the Most High's name, not Christ. And his son's name is Yahweh Shai.
These fools will say God is his name.
Yeah, God. Or what about them retards? You be on the internet talking to somebody, and they'll type God, but they won't spell it all out. They'll put G/D and leave the O out. Like God was sacred or something. Like that, you know, like the word G-O-D was a sacred name. Well, you know, they don't want to spell it all out. They'll spell G/ like a hyphen, D. And I'm like, why you... That's not even... God is not God's name, you freaking retard. People are just dumb. That's what y'all gonna find out, is motherfuckers are just stupid. They're just... dumb.
And wicked.
And wicked. Evil. Yeah. Evil. If you will not hear, and if you will not lay it to heart to give glory unto my name, save the Lord of hosts, I will even send a curse upon you, and I will curse your blessings. Yea, I have cursed them already because you do not lay it to heart. Behold, I will corrupt your seed and spread dung upon your faces. Even the dung of your solemn feasts, and one shall take you away with it. So yeah, it's like we was talking about those feast days, like what, Halloween and Thanksgiving and Christmas and all this other bullshit.
Tis the season.
Yeah, tis the holiday season. Happy holidays, motherfuckers. The Lord is gonna, you're gonna eat that big lavish meal, that honey baked ham, and all this, you know what I mean, all this other.
Say this around the time, last year, around the time you see all that steam comes up from the from the sewer.
Oh, it stinks after Thanksgiving, don't it?
It's funky as fuck.
But the Lord said he's gonna take it after you eat that meal and shit it out, he's gonna wipe that shit on your face. It's right there in the Bible.
That's right.
I just read it. It's right there. That's a Malachi.
Dude, that ham and stroke out on it too.
Yeah, that ham be, we motherfucker take a shit after they ate some pork.
This is the busiest time of year in the hospitals, man.
Has to be. They get all clogged up.
It's the busiest time of year, yeah. It's the busiest time of year, and if you're filling all these ERs up, man, people coming in from issues with their heart and stomach.
All that pork.
Yeah, it's just they're not being disciplined. Just eating and indulging themselves in anything and every fucking thing. You know, you can't tell these people that though.
You can't.
You can eat a little bit of it, but these motherfuckers consume it every fucking
day. A little bit, my ass. They take it to the extreme.
Yeah, right.
And I tell the same people every day, like, why are you eating that fucking swine? Yeah. Well, you know,
it tastes good.
Yeah, as long as it tastes good.
As far as you.
They don't even know what this shit is.
They don't want to be scorned from you.
Yeah.
Because they know you. You know what I'm saying? And look at this motherfucker. I grew up with this nigga, man. You can't tell me shit.
And I don't stop. Every time I see motherfuckers eating swan, I say something.
Damn right.
There's certain shit I might not say something about. I might keep it to myself. But when it comes to that goddamn pork, I can't. I'm going to say something. I'm going to curse your ass out. That shit's foul. Stinking up the goddamn place. That shit does not smell good. It smells like Satan.
Hey, but Pastor Porkchop and Reverend No Law, they said the Lord loves you anyway and he will forgive you.
That's why they all get put to death.
That's right. Here you go. This is Jeremiah 2:8. The priest said not, where is the Lord? And they that handle the law knew me not.
Oh, those that handle the law, that goes back to the priests. Those that handle the law. They don't know the Lord. They don't even keep the law. Keep going. Oh, they go through that John 15 too.
The pastors also transgressed against me, and the prophets prophesied by Baal and walked after things that do not profit.
Yeah, so all these preachers out here, all these churches, starting with the Catholic Church, Baptist Church, they're all prophets of Baal.
Your local nigga church?
Yeah, he's teaching the doctrine of Baal, the devil. He ain't teaching that old sweet Jesus he's talking about is actually the devil.
Damn right.
You know what I mean?
That old sweet Jesus.
That old sweet.
That old sweet Jesus.
They love their sweet Jesus, don't
they?
They
love him. Damn right.
That's actually, they actually really.
Sweet Jesus.
They're teaching about Baal. And some of them don't even know it, you know? But some of them are willingly, there's a lot of them just straight up devil worshipers. And they enjoy deceiving people.
Especially like after we saw the Christian is true. And we tell them how, we talk about it all the time. Man, you a faggot, man. That's, you can prosper.
Yeah.
That's their key. That was their okay. That was their pass. That was their pass. That's all they need to hear was hear that, man.
But I was
that's it.
I was listening to the y'all know who Mark Passio is? Mm-hmm. Italian dude. He was an ex-priest of the Church of Satan, right? And he broke away. He said he got tired of taking advantage of people and shit.
Wow.
He said his conscience was getting with
him. That's a trait.
Yeah, he's Italian dude, yeah. But now, I mean, he seemed like he's still a fucking heathen. But he said that all these satanic priests, they enjoy, they'll actually go into a church, they'll go to seminary school, become a preacher, they infiltrate the churches. So literally speaking, a lot of these preachers in these churches are actually like high priests of Satan. They're actually satanic priests. Like, who knowingly and love Satan.
A lot of them wore them black robes, like the church.
So they've infiltrated all these churches and all these organizations.
That's crazy.
That's why they got homosexual marriages in churches now. They got transgenders. Come on. And then they're trying to use the Bible at the same time while they got transgendered. Transgenders walking on around through their church. That's madness. That's pure mental retardation.
Hey, spirit on.
This is weird. We could take a little girl when she gets older, though.
Yeah, spirit, yeah. It's,
you know what I mean? Yeah. Lizzo, she got a use for her.
Yeah.
We'll do something with her.
Shit. Yeah, you see them dead spirits on that? Was tripping yep. watching them, man.
That is a dead spirit.
It was very blank.
Just like them dead leaves blown in the wind.
Let me get this scripture right here, real quick. You still got scripture?
No.
Yeah, I'm done,
though. Okay. This is Ecclesiasticus 22 and 14. What is heavier than lead, and what is the name thereof but a fool? Sand and salt and a mass of iron is easier to bear than a man without understanding.
Iron heavy as hell.
As timber girt and bound together in a building cannot be loosed with shaking, so the heart that is established by advice counsel shall fear at no time. A heart settled upon a thought of understanding is as a fair plastering on the wall of a gallery. Pale set on a high place will never stand against the wind, so a fearful heart and the imagination of a fool cannot stand against any fear.
The imagination of a fool. Ha! Look at these fools. What do you think these fools imagining in their head all day? This is a bunch of bullshit.
Bunch of folly.
A bunch of folly.
A lot of shit that don't profit.
Nothing ain't profit. Okay, you get tired of being surrounded by retarded people, man. Motherfuckers don't know shit. You can't have a halfway decent conversation with nobody.
Go ahead, bro.
Oh, no, I'm just saying, like, what are you supposed to talk? The only thing you can talk to them about is football. Maybe video games, and that's about it.
That's right.
That's all they know about.
Yeah, that scripture itself is like pretty much was saying in its own another way that these people don't have a foundation of wisdom. That foundation, a solid foundation. So they, like I said, that up on a hill,
they blow the fuck over.
Right. That's where the wind is blowing heavily, and that's where structures come down easily up on that hill, man. I be up at Howland Creek walking the path, man, and it's up high, up near the dam, and that wind up there is always blowing, man. You always feel a breeze. But that's how these people are. They're unstable. They're about to collapse.
Yep.
They're gonna collapse at the right moment, man.
At
that pointed moment.
That east wind.
That east wind, all right. Hot, that dry.
They're gonna get hit with that east wind.
Shit.
Shit, spiritually, they already been hit with it.
Mm-hmm.
Shit.
Yeah.
Soon that real east wind
dry
is gonna
bones.
Come in.
Dry bones.
Yeah, they dry bones. These people are just a joke, man.
As they should be. As they're supposed to be.
Yeah, they're supposed to be.
They're appointed to be that way. We were chosen to do this. They were chosen to do what they do. You know?
That is true. All right, bring it out. You got it? Shit.
Oh, yeah.
What? Oh, go ahead.
It's a hearse.
Yeah, 28. 14. Wherefore, hear the word of Yahweh, the scorn from men, that ruled this people which is in Jerusalem. Because ye have said, we have made a covenant with death, and with hell are we at agreement.
Ain't nothing like a nigga that just got his mind set out just to do evil. Ain't nothing like it, man. And check it out. I can't remember if it's California or all over the U.S., but there's like over 6,000 prisoners that's about to be released onto the streets.
Oh, yeah.
You know, is that just California?
I don't know, but I did hear something about that.
They're just about to be released because they're not taking care of them no more.
They can't afford it.
Right, right. That's just a small number, man. That's just a beginning of bad times.
Well, I heard too. I was talking to somebody last night about how you were on the hilltop. They used to have the nut house.
Yeah.
Remember how they shut that down?
It's still there. They just they built an expansion.
But there was a bigger one back in the day, wasn't it? And they let them all out.
Well, they moved it over.
Oh, okay.
They built a whole new one. It's all a right. flat, it ain't a big tall building. Cause you can't see it going down Sullivan, or you might be able to see it on Sullivan. Is that Sullivan I'm thinking about?
I always get confused.
What's that broad street and the next street over?
Sullivan.
Okay, it's right in between there.
Oh, okay.
Okay, it's right being right there where Tico is too. On the west end of Tico, there's another building. Yeah. The old building.
Oh, so that, I remember the old nut house.
The old one is gone.
Yeah.
Like you were saying, the old one's gone. But they expand, they just built more, you know. They can make more money, man, by letting these motherfuckers collect Social Security or somehow the government.
But there's some crazy bugged out motherfuckers out here.
Yeah.
It's getting worse.
Can't pay for them no more. They just letting them out, man. Just letting them out. Well, that's good, though. That's good.
It is good.
You know? They're taking those steps to push that martial law.
Yep.
Like, they always complain about the Mexicans invading. That's good. Even though I hate Muslims and Muslims are heathen, I think it's good that they're invading shit, man. Shit needs to be invaded, fucked up, and destroyed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It has its purpose.
There's an end to the, method to the madness. But like the Most High works in mysterious ways.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But that's beautiful though, man. Once they give them the streets, man, you think they gonna fit back into society? Gonna get a tie job?
Right.
You know what
they
I'm
gonna go rape, they gonna rob, they gonna
the
kill.
The same shit. And that's 6,000, that's a lot of motherfucking people, man.
And they ready to get out.
That's a lot of motherfuckers. Yeah. They planted.
They had no pussy in a minute.
Man, that kilo I got buried. You know?
They've been plotting and scheming.
Yeah. Because
you know prison is just
6,000, huh?
6,000.
Because
prison is that's like the university going to college for criminals.
They come out smarter
in their wickedness. They learn all kind of tricks while they're in there. Sharing their hood knowledge with each other.
Right, one big cesspool.
Yeah. Just imagine when them prison doors open permanently, baby. When they ain't got no choice but to open. Let them out. When they might just break out, you know, because these are just some open doors. Right.
That prison shit's some bullshit anyway.
Yeah, that's some magic.
Show me in the law where it said you gotta put people in prison.
The motherfucker that worked in prison, the worst individuals that's in the prison.
You see all the laws in the Bible. Most laws that you break usually end with the punishment of death. Like if you commit adultery is punishable by death. Murder is punishable by death.
Out here being a hoe.
But out here, you can murder somebody in America and get 7-8 years. Yeah. They'll let you go. What kind of madness is that?
Yeah.
You should supposed to get put to death. You got a quick trial. We're going to give you a trial. Get the witnesses up here. All right, now hang that motherfucker.
Yep.
That's how they used to do it.
Yep. Right in front of the home. You know, people go buy popcorn. Come on, kids. Get on the wagon.
Get on the wagon. We're going to watch a hanging
today. We're going to town. Kids go excited. We're going to the city.
Yeah. We're going downtown, baby. Got the good clothes.
Big event.
To watch this piece of shit get hung.
That's right.
And then everybody clap and praise the Lord.
Yep. Same hymns.
And they probably did sing hymns.
Yeah, sure did.
Because you see somebody get hung for murder, that'll put fear of the Lord in your ass.
I'm trying to think of the one with Clint Eastwood got hung, but he lived.
Oh, that's the painter, Town Red or something. That's the one he was a spirit.
Remember he was hung.
You talking about the spaghetti western?
Clint Eastwood, when he was hung, but he lived.
But somebody shot it down.
But the mayor hired him to actually go hunt them same dudes, and he got them all.
Yeah. That was that spaghetti western. That was $2
I can't remember. Badass movie though. But in the movie, there was hangings. There was local.
Yeah, there was all kind of hangings. Yeah, that's a good shit. But somebody that won't put the fear in people.
Oh man.
Seeing somebody get hung or get stoned to death, that will make people think twice about doing some wickedness.
That's how the slave masters was able to mentally conquer the slaves.
Oh yeah.
They beat the shit out of them. Would actually take a couple of motherfucking slaves, especially a black slave woman, slice her stomach open in front of all the crowd and let that baby hang, man. And that would fuck you up mentally. Like, shit, I'm gonna be the best slave tomorrow. Just like after your dad whooped your ass, you know you were the best acting child the next 2-3 days until that wears off.
That's why they don't want you to whoop your kids now, though.
Oh, yeah.
They don't want you because that put the fear in them. And then when we actually make them behave.
Yeah.
I ain't trying to get no ass whooping.
You know what I'm saying?
They want these kids that's what they are, too, kids.
Yeah, kids.
Just running around, just chickens with the head cut off.
Just like Isaiah says that women and children rule over them.
Yep. Women are their oppressors. Children are their oppressors.
Yeah.
And it meant just that, too. It means just that. Let me might as well get that since we mentioned it.
Yeah, because, man, there's hardly no punishment for any crime no more. They'll send you to prison forever. And then the prisoners are just free slave labor for the fucking white man. You're getting paid.
Esau. Shit.
Yeah, they get like, what, 5 cents a month or some shit?
It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. They get out with a $100 check.
For 20 years.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. And
that
money they get out with is just enough to get some bus fare from the prison to wherever local city you're going to. And that's probably $20-$30 of the money.
How many times have we met a dude out here like, I just got out of prison? All the time, man.
Oh, man.
They be broke as hell, just struggling.
Yep.
Don't know where to go.
Yep. You watch Sling Blade. Sling Blade got out with some money.
Oh, yeah.
He got some bus fare. He went and bought him some
biscuits.
French fried potatoes. And some biscuits.
Some biscuits.
Mustard.
Some mustard. My dude in that movie is your boy Dwight Yoakam.
Oh, dude, you got his head cracked. Yeah, that's my dude.
He played the hell out there.
He made the movie, actually.
That's a Jake for your ass right there, Dwight Yoakam. He's from Columbus.
Straight up?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He went to North High School.
Oh, hell.
That goes to show you the state this place is in. That a motherfucking someone retarded and shit all fucked up. We'll get put on a pedestal.
Yeah, they that monthly check they get is fat one, man. It's like $600-$700 now. You know?
Damn.
And they're given jobs because these people, like some old patients of mine work at Lowe's and Kroger's and Myers up north. These motherfuckers can't do nothing but push carts in and out. They don't do nothing else, man.
They get paid.
Yep. And the government is paying those jobs to keep them motherfuckers on the job.
Go to Walmart. They always get some fucking retard at the door checking your receipt.
Yep.
Talking about, I'm not seeing a receipt.
Right.
I'm like, bitch, get away from
wheelchair
me.
Wheelchair and shit.
I'm like, don't even fucking touch me, man. You know what I mean? I almost get in a fight every time I go to Walmart.
The government actually pays them jobs, man, to keep them people. Useless people in society ain't doing nothing else. Just totally
they
useless.
They need to be
somewhere
having their family take care of. They don't need to be working at Walmart trying to buy some shit. You waiting in line for a goddamn half hour because some fucking retards at the register.
See, I went to Arby's yesterday. It took me like 45 minutes to get my sandwich.
Yeah, just fuck.
Damn, what? That's because they bullshit.
These motherfuckers are worthless.
Full of women?
No, I was watching them the whole time. I went inside to get it.
That's why when I go to the grocery store or any store, I always go to the line where it's got the young man working in the line.
Oh, so he's going
to
get you out of there.
He be checking that shit like, do.
He's efficient.
Yeah, efficient.
He's more efficient.
Yep.
These women just
take their time. Then they complaining about everything.
You know, looking over at the next aisle, see what that girl doing.
Yeah, checking her Facebook.
Right.
You get
all the time, man.
Women have no business working anywhere.
Literally, man. But at home.
At home.
That's it. I'm tired of seeing this shit.
Yeah,
man.
You get tired. Go to the B&B, try to get some fucking shit for your car. Number of women in there. The most inefficient operation on the planet.
Bitch will have it. I said 3 as well. Ask for my people.
That's the nation of Israel.
Right. Children are their oppressors, and women rule over them. Oh, my people, they which lead thee, cause thee to err.
Yeah, women rule over. Just like when you go to the B&B, you trying to get tags or something, and you got some bitch fingernails this goddamn long, fat as hell, and she's in charge, you know, running shit, telling you what to do.
They which lead thee cause thee to err and destroy the way of thy paths. Don't follow these bitches.
Yeah, fuck yourself.
Plain and simple.
That's why you got all these women politicians. People talking about Hillary for 2016.
Yeah, right.
It'd be a miracle.
She's very popular now.
Oh, really?
You know, the way shit heating up now, man.
I've been seeing her face a lot on that thing.
Yeah, it's annoying seeing that bitch's face too, man.
But you can still, these people are still off in goddamn dreamland.
Yeah.
They still believe in this fucking in this facade they got going. These motherfuckers are clueless out here. They ain't got a clue about what's really going on.
That's right.
About how the world operates.
That's right. They're gonna learn that talk when the missiles start to fall.
That's good.
When that calamity starts, when the destruction starts, they gonna all fall in line. That's gonna be some funny shit. Like, damn.
Oh, what you got?
What you looking for?
He's over there digging deep. Bring it out, man. You gotta bring it out.
It was a topic about the, you know, getting punished, probably, whatever. But it's Ecclesiasticus 23 and 21. This man shall be punished in the streets of the city, and where he suspected not, he shall be taken
openly. People gonna see it's gonna be made public.
Yep.
Just like we praying for, like them wicked ass Farrah clown, Jesse Jackass. I mean, the list goes on.
And they need
on
to get a public execution.
Yep, 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 yep. So people can be like, damn, he got fucked up.
Just like they got Mussolini.
Oh,
remember how they got Mussolini and his wife?
Yep.
They beat the hell out of Mussolini till you couldn't even recognize him. Strung his ass up on a goddamn rope.
Bitch.
Let's see if I can find the pictures, bro. You want to see some fucked up shit.
Mussolini, boy, he got it.
He took advantage of the people, man.
Yeah, he took advantage of them. Yeah, definitely.
The guy hit in the car in his rag. Or no, I think that was the
Mussolini was, he was the dictator of Italy during World War II.
Oh, okay.
And yeah,
living fat. He was living fat,
while
man.
While his people were starving.
Look, this motherfucker in his house, man, he had, like, under his beds and his closets, buried in the floors, gold, and, I mean, just name it, man. The list was crazy. Plus, he was dealing with, I'm trying to think of if it's the Queen of England, the English.
I need to study that more.
Yeah, yeah, because that's some bad shit, man. It's just funny how this motherfucker was, like, doing this shit openly, man. He didn't give a shit, but the people revolted. Just like America, these motherfuckers can go after these politicians.
Yeah, they been to do it. They getting close.
Y'all see that that tax they're trying to pass with the zoo levy.
Oh, yeah.
They've been trying to get that pay thing passed for years now, man, but now it's going to get through.
It says there's no new tax.
Shit downtown.
Yeah, and the funny thing is, when that tax go up, it's going to continuously go up.
Yeah.
It's not going to stop. It's not going to have a window.
He's not wearing his panda suit.
A ceiling. It's going to, every year it's going to go up and up. These people just love oppressing people, man. They just love oppression, man. But the people don't see it. They're not going to see it until they can't feed that baby that's continuously crying. You know, that's when they want to wake up. And like I said, when that calamity come knocking, kick the door down on me. Yeah. Always say knocking. That door don't mean knock no more.
And you always know too. Every time you tell
that's
these.
That's in the heat of the moment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, that's when they're waking up.
Yeah.
That's when they want to wake up. I mean, Roman said, it is high time to awake out of sleep.
Yeah, now is the time. Not fucking tomorrow, not next week.
Wait, we've been out here for years.
Why you always say, but you tell the woman about the taxes. I'm ready. You tell a bitch about taxes, like, you know, the taxes are unconstitutional, income taxes. I'm like, we need taxes. You gotta pay your taxes. How else is stuff gonna run?
You know them bitches making too much to worry about here.
That's why we don't care about women, man. We're not trying to wake up women.
Pay taxes.
Only thing we're trying to do with women is to get their number, man. That's it.
Get their number? Fuck that. Hit it and quit it.
Yeah, that's all they good for. Anything quit.
Well, they'll quit it anyway, so.
They done result to concubine, pretty much.
Yeah, that's all they are. These hoes is concubines. They bed winces. Go ahead.
27.
Hold on, wait till this fucking.
Thank God when demons are leaving.
President of Barack Obama.
Yeah, she been running around.
Over there talking about some goddamn Obama.
Yeah, bull dagger. That's a bull dagger too. Yeah, that's a bull dagger. You can tell it's a bull dagger.
Yeah, take your ass on the bus.
Yeah, get the fuck out of here.
Motherfucker's still on that Obama shit. That don't even make no sense.
Stupid.
I mean, how dumb are you?
Yeah, he's about to be up out of there and all them bills he passed.
That thing.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, the bad one of them all was the NDAA and the TPP.
He got him. What about gay marriage? And gay marriage.
Yeah.
He said these Negroes.
Get it.
You know what I mean? Passed all those bills, you know. Somebody else is going to get up in there.
Set them up.
That's Obama's legacy. It's gay marriage, TPP,
and the NDAA.
Yep.
That's some bad shit. That's some bad shit. So they always talking this shit, how like Trump, we're gonna bring jobs back. We're gonna build, we're gonna make it, we're gonna make this toilet called America great again. How the fuck you gonna do that when a job's got the authorization to leave now?
They say he's gonna make it great again. I didn't know it was ever great to begin with.
Slavery was great, I guess.
It's toilets. Oh man.
But
it's not bouncing back.
I'm skipping 27. And they that remain shall know that there is nothing better than the fear of the Lord, and that there is nothing sweeter than to take heed unto the commandments of the Lord. It is great glory to follow the Lord and to receive of him his long life.
Hey, brush that picture. That's a good point. To follow them commandments. Why you blowing that up? I'm going to give this scripture. This is a precept. This backs up what he just read. John 15 and 10. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. So these fools out here, they're not keeping the commandments of the Lord. They all eating on swine's flesh. You know what I'm saying? They all adulterers, faggots, freaks. Fucking, they're all taking, they break all the commandments, man. They laugh, if you even mention the commandments, they laugh at you.
Yeah, they took it to where, like, the commandments is, ancient.
Yeah,
like,
it's ancient. That's
they were in Bible times.
That's a relic from the past. The
commandments goes ancient. Like, that don't even apply to now. Like,
it really don't, because adultery is rampant. That's one of the Ten Commandments. Adultery is rampant. And the scripture said don't covet that neighbor's property, right?
Right.
That's all people do. Everybody's envious of each other. They want to take your shit. Everybody wants what you got. Including your wife, your kids.
That's fucked up.
Yeah.
Rappers, they still goddamn rich. Why the hell can they get the elk?
Right.
They don't want the elk. See, it's part of their pleasure. They get satisfaction out of taking your woman.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's that wickedness. That fulfills their wicked
demons.
Demons.
That's it. That's just crazy.
Because if they had their own woman, it wouldn't be fulfilling to them.
Because there's way more women out there than there is men.
All that money.
There's definitely ain't no shortage.
Yeah, right.
There ain't no shortage. Never was a shortage.
And they'll deal with a man's woman.
That's part of that faggot spirit, man. They get gratification out of fucking going in another man's pussy. Taking your shit.
That didn't sound right.
That's nasty, man. That's nasty as fuck.
Another
man.
Man's bitch.
Because if you got a woman, you busting lots of nuts.
Yeah.
A lot of nut in that bitch's mouth and her ass. Her ass.
And dudes be sharing bitches too.
Yeah, yeah.
They'll pass a bitch around the same night.
And the same dudes be fucking guys in the ass. They ain't going to go fuck these hoes.
Yeah.
We ain't even making that up either.
And when they get an affection, they're not surprised because they knew it was coming. They didn't care anyway.
They like him new affection.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They hoping to get that bitch an affection or the next bitch or the next bitch.
I heard.
So that break the family up anyway.
I heard some faggots saying that getting a disease was a rite of passage.
Oh, boy.
That's like an initiation and then being a faggot, getting your first disease.
You got free clinics.
I forget where I seen that. They was bragging about it. But somebody confronted them about diseases and they said, oh, that's a rite of passage or something.
That's some foul shit.
Like, what? Fucking, they was serious too.
Yeah, that's some foul shit.
Your homie Mark says he goes to World Harvest now.
Oh, really?
Who's going to World Harvest?
Dude, Mark.
The whole time I was in there, he's talking about his gay boyfriend locked up.
Oh, shit. The World Harvest will accept him with Rob Parsley.
Yeah.
Rob Parsley, he looked like a big cum guzzler. Hey, look at that picture. Did you already get that on camera? That's Mussolini and his wife hung upside down, dead.
Can't even recognize him. Look at their faces.
Get that on camera.
Can't even recognize their face, man.
Yeah, made a spectacle of
them. Mm-hmm. Made a public example. That's right.
There's going to be a lot of that coming.
A lot of them.
Y'all thought the French Revolution was bad?
Oh,
shit.
Man.
Wait till you see it's coming to this motherfucker.
Oh, you think the American Revolution was bad?
Oh, they thought slavery was bad.
They think thought slavery was bad.
They thought that was bad.
Right. Yeah. They have no idea.
I mean, shit's gonna get evil.
Evil.
That's the best word.
Evil is already evil.
Well, we're talking about
is time.
We're talking about the good evil.
Ill is bad.
Yeah.
Evil.
Well, evil.
Evil. Right.
Is a, you know, but the Lord is going to bring some evil upon the wicked. If they like wickedness, the Lord will give them some wickedness. You know what I mean?
Who just read that scripture? They made a covenant with death. And, go ahead, bro. Do what you need to do, bro. Because all these scriptures is relevant.
Yeah, all of them.
All of them.
The old and the new.
Oh, man. We
goes Waldo.
We're not New Testament prophets, Old Testament prophets. Shit.
So, yeah, there's no new thing under the sun.
Isaiah 28:14 But ye have said, we have made a covenant with death and with hell, or we have agreements. When the overflowing spores shall pass through, it shall not come unto us. For we have made lies our refuge, and under falsehood have we hid ourselves. Therefore, thus says the Lord God.
That's his whole goddamn society. This whole system is founded on lies. Why do you think that the Congress has, what, like a 20% approval rate?
God.
Because everybody knows they're fucking liars.
That's right. They're catching on to that shit.
Yeah, I mean, they've been caught on to that. That's why Donald Trump got so popular. Yeah. You know, because he's not a politician.
You'd be more entertaining than Bush, I'll tell you that.
I don't know. You ain't nobody more entertaining than Bush.
That's going to be...
It's hard. I don't know. Donald Trump's up there, though. He talks a lot of
can't
shit.
Can't fuck with Bush.
Can't fuck with Bush. Sorry, dude.
Donald Trump, man.
They be talking some shit, don't they?
Donald Trump's an entertainer. Bush wasn't an entertainer.
That's not his personality. He's just his public personality.
Yeah, he's an actor.
Bush, that was Bush.
Yeah, Bush was being real.
He goes stitches.
Because Bush was, that was Bush, man. He was the fucking president of the United States, man. Like, arrogant, that brings arrogancy out, man.
Yep.
You know, that was Bush.
Yeah, George Bush is a true American.
Yeah, true American.
You're either with us or you're with the terrorists.
That's right. That's right.
They was not fucking around, dude.
A Texan too?
He's not even from Texas. He's from Maine.
His family owned Buckeye Steel.
Fake ass hillbilly.
You know, his family started Buckeye Steel.
The Bushes. Yeah. Prescott. I think it was Prescott.
Yeah, Prescott. They sold all the metal to Germany.
Yeah. Yeah, they were supporters of the National Socialists.
4:2
You
still got more to that scripture?
But Henry Ford, he was a Israelite for your ass.
Yeah.
A black permanent marker would be good right now.
He was always clashing with them Jews.
The Jews. He one of the most successful businessmen in America's history, and he knew how the world ran. You know, he dealt with the biggest money makers and biggest, you know, with everybody. So he knew who the fuck was running shit.
Right.
And he'd tell you that it was the goddamn Jews was the ones running shit.
That's right.
Anyone got a black Sharpie?
A black shirt?
Sharpie.
Oh, no, why?
Make the sign say, Explore Columbus with your fuck ID.
That's messed up. Yeah, all you'd have to do is just black out the little parts on the B.
Yeah.
Like, throw the sign right there.
He likes to vandalize stuff.
Oh, shit. Tagging shit.
I like tagging shit.
Is that the original, what's his name, Banksy or Banksy?
Banksy?
No, he revealed his identity.
Is that really Banksy?
Didn't he reveal himself?
He's got a meet and greet in New York this month.
Oh, was it?
No.
Oh, you got him, huh?
Yeah.
I didn't even see it. Yeah, Banksy is talented, man.
Yeah,
he's supposed to do a meet and greet in New York City.
He's probably like one of the most famous artists alive today. And nobody even knows who the fuck he is. He's got to be some rich dude. There's no way else you could do that without being extremely wealthy.
All that material. Shit ain't shit.
Hey,
what did
you read? Bring that out.
Isaiah 28. And 15 again. Because you have said, we have made a covenant with death and with hell, we had agreement. If the overflowing scourge shall pass, when the overflowing scourge shall pass through, It's not coming to us. But we have made lies our refuge, and under falsehood, have we hid ourselves.
Yeah. I'm sorry, but yeah, these people, they made a covenant with death out here. The whole American culture is a culture of death. That's why everybody got skull tattoos, skulls on their shirt. You go to the store, Walmart, any store where you buy clothes. I don't fucking know the names of all these stores. But almost half the shirts, if not more, got some kind of skulls on this shit.
Walmart, Myers.
Yeah, Walmart, Myers, you know, you Target.
I go in Macy's. Macy's full of
it.
Just
skulls everywhere. Yep. Tattoos of skulls everywhere. Then plus Halloween, but...
I thought that was a fad that came in as on die out. It's not going anywhere.
But all the video games are all about death and murder and blood. Thanksgiving.
Yeah. And they walk around with that shit proud too.
Even Nintendo said, they said they was against all these other companies making all these violent video games, and they said they're not video games, they're murder simulators.
Yeah.
Because Nintendo don't make that shit with all that killing and murder.
Yeah.
They, you know, they got some kind of...
It's more family oriented.
Yeah, more family.
Didn't your boy say he was trying to make a 4D reality? Or like,
Miyamoto?
So he could just close his eyes and be inside the video game?
Yeah.
Right.
Nintendo makes the best shit. Because I like Nintendo games, yeah, because it's not all... All that first-person shit is garbage. All the first-person shooters,
go around opening up chests. Looking for rupees.
That shit don't even stimulate your mind at all. You just murdering. They tell you the CIA was behind the development of a lot of these video games because getting these young kids ready to fight in the military and fight in wars for them. Mm-hmm. And they're pretty much just giving you military training.
What was that movie, The Toy, where they had the...
The Toy with Robin Williams and LL Cool J.
Yeah.
You
remember that? LL Cool J was in that shit?
Yeah. And when they showed you they had little kids, they thought they was playing a video game. But it was really controlling
drones.
It was controlling drones, killing people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's, go watch it again. You'll see. There's some truth in it.
Yeah, because I was a little child when that, like, you know, I was.
It came out in the '90s, didn't it?
Yeah, it was like early '90s.
Yeah, it was your girl.
91 or some shit.
Yeah, early.
Man, you talk to a kid now, man. Especially got video games. Never seen a gun in real life, but they can name every fucking strat, man.
Right.
Every last one. Cause that.
Yeah, because
Call of Duty.
Call of Duty is all real weapons and shit.
Yeah.
For the most part.
Yeah.
And that
seen a gun in your life, man.
Like little kids these days, they don't like Mario. They don't like Sonic. Really, I mean, they like them, but they want to play Call of Duty.
Yeah.
You ask any little kid what game you want to play, he's going to say Call of Duty.
And they do label the games mature.
Yeah, there's nothing but kids to play.
Yeah.
Now it's all grown up people playing the Nintendo shit.
They used to tell us not to smoke cigarettes. We did it just because they told us not to.
Just because they told you not to, you know.
But even look at the blunts. When you go to the store, all the blunt wraps, all the Swisher sweets, and they're all marketed towards children. They got strawberry flavored, lemon flavored, like candy flavor. That's targeted towards young people.
They got a lot of cigarettes and shit, like little candy cigarettes.
Yeah, candy cigarettes.
They do that with tattoos too.
They got the bubblegum cigars.
Oh, that's why tattoos weathered up.
That's why they got the drinks like the Four Loko, all the different.
Yeah.
They get you fucked up. It's just some rock gut shit. But it's got them.
No,
I don't drink that shit either. I just like.
I know that's just good for
you. You gotta give it to me straight. I don't like all that fruity shit.
Shit, back in the day, they got me with St. Ives Special Brew.
Yeah, St. Ives Special Brew. They wanted. The Special Brew. That shit was.
Oh
fuck,
man.
That have you puking your guts out. But they put Snoop Dogg in the commercial.
But this shit was so delicious. It tastes like fruit punch, but it was smooth as fuck. But
it's marketed
your ass
towards
twisted.
Young people.
Yeah. I remember they used to have that commercial on BET and shit.
Because when you get old, you don't like want to drink. A real man going to drink his beers, some real beer.
Yeah.
Not no fruity shit.
Because I'm older and I got an expensive taste. I don't drink none of shit. It's just me.
If I'm drinking liquor, I don't want all that girly shit.
This
give it to me raw.
That's what she said.
Gave me like a little six pack. For like a tip after we got done. And it was some some
Ephraimite?
Yeah. And it was some good ass beer, man. It was called like Del Negro. I can't like
Del bottle. Negro, that's the
you know what I'm talking.
Are you drinking
black
Modelo?
Bottle. Yeah.
Modelo.
That's the black bottle, with the gold foil on it.
Yeah.
We used to get that all the time.
Man, that shit
was pretty good.
Yeah, it was fucking delicious, man.
But you know, if you think about it, it's these parents' business. It's their fault for buying these videos for these children, man. You know? Mm-hmm. They're part of the problem brainwashing the kids, man. They're brainwashing the kids. The parents is actually part of the problem.
There is a scripture where they tell you, raise a child in the right way as they go.
So right.
That's the same way dealing with the left-hand side.
I tell that to my sons all the time. Yeah. That Call of Duty, every time I see them want to play, I'm like, that's fucking garbage.
Yeah, because I bought my kids some video games too, man. But I mean, it's a difference between a motherfucker that's going to teach their kids shit and don't tell them nothing. Yeah. And apparently, it's a big difference between somebody that actually teaches their kids and telling them something. And I mean, it is not something.
Because there are some games like some of them RPGs.
There you go.
They'll have a little history and shit in it. My one son, he likes those strategy games. We got the historical, like Age of Empires.
Right.
Where you get to play as the Scots with the, what's the dude from Braveheart? What's the motherfucker's name? Robert the Bruce, you get to play as him, or you get to play as the Normans, or you get to play as the you can, and it teaches you about history, all the historical armies.
You can
play as the Byzantine Empire. You know, games like that's good for kids.
Right. Yeah, but these motherfuckers, they just throw the bottle game for these goddamn kids, man, and just don't. Just
that's
don't
their babysitter for the day.
Yeah, that's why a lot of people, that's why they babysit. They just throw the park a little bastard right in front of the TV.
Like mom, she used to get Barney tapes for Sarah and make her watch Barney all day and not give a fuck about it. That shit was terrible.
Isaiah 3.
Torture.
And I would give children to be the princes, and babes shall rule over them. And the people shall be oppressed, every one by another, and every one by his neighbor. The child shall behave himself proudly against the ancient, and the base against the honorable.
Yeah, that's these little bastards. They got no respect for nobody. You know,
respect not a person.
Well, it's a different kind of respect. Respect, saying no respect to persons means, and judgment, saying just because this guy's your friend doesn't mean it's okay for him to fucking break a law and to somebody you don't know. Or if someone's poor and if someone's rich, you treat them both the same.
Like those little badass kids.
But there's different kinds of respect, though.
Some badass kids wasn't respecting.
Yeah.
What was it, Alicia?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
they disrespected
them. Yeah, that was totally disrespectful.
That was no respect.
Especially back then?
I mean, it's just certain shit you're supposed to teach your children, man. Like, if somebody does something for them, you say thank you. You know, simple
shit. What do you say?
They ain't got that these days, you little bastards.
I got scripture. This is Baruch 3 and 20. Young men have seen light and dwelt upon the earth, but the way of knowledge have they not known.
Yeah, no knowledge, none.
Nor understood the paths thereof, nor laid hold of it. Their children were far off from that way.
That's a good one, yeah. Far off. Like, way the fuck off. These little children, they dumb as a fucking box of goddamn rocks, man.
Just like the mom and dad.
They don't know shit. And the schools ain't teaching them nothing. And then the parents will actually leave it up to the schools to educate their children.
Yeah.
Like, oh, my, that school ain't teaching you nothing.
And yeah, then they'll be like, you better be getting good grades in school. Like, fuck school, that's what I say. How about you teach them, little motherfuckers?
I always had a problem just sitting there in class.
I hated school.
My son
talked. You know, we meant to be like, we're men.
Smartest thing I ever did was drop out of school.
That was the smartest thing you probably ever did, huh?
My youngest son told me that his teacher's gay. He's got to go to school. Yeah. He's got a faggot teacher.
Right. My teacher is faggot.
Yeah, ain't he in elementary school?
I said faggots or whatever. So she now ever since she's looking at me all weird.
Oh, well, fuck her.
She a dyke.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
That's good.
Faggots
though,
should not be allowed in elementary schools.
She knows,
for real. You know.
Yeah, because there's that one teacher that got caught putting sperm in the kid's lunch.
What's his name?
Yeah, he got caught. He was actually, he'd been doing it for a long time, feeding him sperm. He'd probably been doing it for years.
Yeah.
The kid probably was growing fond of it.
Been doing it. Yeah. Hell yeah.
And then when they finally caught him, they didn't want to bust him because they was doing it too. They said, but they didn't want the word to get out. They had to throw him under the bus.
See, shit like that. That's what they mean, land of the free. Yeah. Shit like that.
Yeah, do what you do.
Yeah, doing foul shit like
that's
that.
That's part of that. No, because
not get caught.
That's what they meant. Yeah.
Free to not.
Just like I was saying that, that Mark Passio dude I was talking about, he was in the Church of Satan, and he said all these Satanists, they were actually members of the Church of Satan, they get jobs in schools. They become principals. They become cops. They become firemen. They get
congressmen,
senators.
Mm-hmm. It goes on and on.
It goes on and on.
I told you about the my graduation, my sister's graduation last year, and some random Freemason came up and he started speaking up there.
Wow.
And, yeah, because
wow.
He just came up to my principal and he starts. Nobody knows who he is. And he's just like a
Freemason.
He just
comes out of nowhere.
And he got the little.
He's like the wizard.
Wow.
Freemason
thing.
He's the grand wizard.
And he just gas speaks.
Damn.
I was the only one looking like.
Like you caught your eye.
You can see it.
But everybody else didn't even see it.
Yeah, everybody else, yeah.
That's spiritual. That was spiritual.
Everybody else probably thought he was up there kicking knowledge, too.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Probably throwing Texas spells.
Yeah. But
yeah,
that's what
yeah,
a graduation
yeah.
is anyway.
Putting all type of spells on.
Graduate. You know, they're just low-level Masons. You know?
Well, that's why you get a degree.
Yeah, there you go.
You get a
you
degree.
Go. That's all it is.
What the hell is a degree? A degree, that's Freemasonic terminology.
Yep, the stripe yep. on your belt is a degree?
Low levels. Low levels of degree. Degrees yeah. is different.
That's why you graduate. You yep. gradually go up.
Step by step.
Yeah.
Helson's at 8th or 9th degree red belt.
Is that, did they call it degrees in jiu-jitsu?
Yes. 8th, 9th degree.
That's a weird-ass Edomite bitch right there.
That bitch look weird as hell. Look like her asshole exploded. Get her on camera. She walking funny as hell. Oh, that's
she
them high
that's
hills.
Some hills. That's some hills.
She can't walk in them hills.
Yeah. You should have saw when she's right there, though.
Nurse.
She had a weird face.
Yeah, tell you how dumb these women are. They'll wear them heels, but it fucks their feet up.
They wear them in the winter. We still don't.
And they're slipping, falling, breaking their legs.
Mm-hmm. They do it, too.
Talking about retarded. How about you get some boots?
A woman just has to be
What's
cute.
Up, Joe?
A woman just has to be cute. She just got
so
to be
can
seen.
I
she just got to be seen.
I actually tell you one thing.
Nope.
All I have to you say nope.
Go ahead, bro. Go on.
You say nope.
Go on, talk to us, man.
Oh, come on. Man. Oh, there. Nope.
You
man.
Said nope.
That's him, oh, man. We brothers, man.
He's just fucking with you.
Yeah, he's just messing with you.
Come on with it. Let's hear it. Bring it on out. Come on. Don't tease us.
Short and glassy. And you guess for the blessings. And you do the blessings. And nor do you keep everybody stupid. Keep you resolute and understand where your real faction come from and understand where your real heart is in.
Right.
Because that's what brings them back in. Because this is a foundation of something that has never been really understood.
My man.
But it has been a resolution confounded.
Amen to that. Oh, bro. Amen to that.
The truth. Keep your resolution back
right.
to your whole congregation. Because this is the foundation that built bricks and built every foundation.
That's right.
This is a solid foundation.
That's right.
May y'all be blessed.
That's right.
I'm down.
All right, brother.
I'm down. My man.
I'm down.
My man.
I'm
down. My man.
All right.
Hey, bro, he got it in. He said that this was the
I thought
foundation.
He was about to start rapping.
What's up, man?
Me too.
What's up, man? You know you initial like?
DJ Calamacito.
Come here for a second, man. Come here, man.
Benaki. Oh,
man, they just don't.
Quita de mi camino, El Diablo.
Oh, that motherfucker knows two or three words. Shit. Best believe he watching motherfucking TV.
Oh, yeah.
You
oh,
know, yeah. they love Westerns.
Oh, they do. They love
motherfuckers
John,
love
they
Western.
They love Western. They love
hasta la vista.
Huh?
Tell him, hasta la vista.
They usually, yeah. They don't
Living
use
la
that.
Vida loca.
Yeah, them Mexicans love goddamn
Western. They love. They scholars on Western. Yeah. Spaghetti Western.
You go out to the Mexican flea market, they got all the Westerns with the subtitles.
Yeah, they sure do. They sure do.
And it's hard to come by to get them with the subtitles.
I didn't even know they made a lot of them over there like that, man. I didn't even know that.
But they got the Mexicans, they do it on their free time. They'll do the subtitles themselves.
Damn.
Just so their brothers can watch that shit. Yep. John Wayne and Spanish.
American Westerns. They stuck on stupid on that shit, man.
Hey, I don't blame them. That's my favorite shit, too.
Motherfuckers don't know English. That motherfucker know English.
No, son.
He ain't walking up and down this motherfucking street not knowing
I was speaking Spanish. He still didn't respond.
Yeah, you can't really survive in America without knowing
shit,
English.
5-0 pull his ass over. I bet you'll learn a few words quick then.
I don't know. He could have been Brazilian speaking Portuguese.
Nah, he was a Mexican. No, you know them Brazilians when you see them.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, this motherfucker skipping to the loo.
He looked like he was skipping. I don't know who this nigga is. Y'all be commenting on the YouTube page, man. This nigga clowning, man.
Oh, what's his name?
I'm about to start attacking his ass.
Don't say his name.
The rapper dude.
Oh, don't say his name.
That motherfucker stupid. Now he made his video on the scriptures now. He delved into the scriptures.
His whole game.
Somebody was trying to hack our YouTube account. I got a message from Google.
For real?
Strong essence presence. Lessons. Strike before a second, but at the same time, you're always going to your resolution, you never have to. But here's the Holy Spirit. Get back to your home. All right. Really?
Hey, that's not.
You said really? Yeah. Really? That's you. That's you.
Okay.
Yours for you comes down for your.
You a fortune teller?
No. It's coming from above.
Oh, you an angel?
Hey.
I'm an archangel.
Hey. You drunk?
Nah, bro.
Yeah. But I'm an archangel.
Right, let's read some scripture, you know what I'm saying? You're getting a little too close, you know what I'm saying?
It's all given. Oh, you ain't want me to get to you?
Nah, it's just too
and
close.
And you got a whole lot of... You know what?
I'm gonna stop.
I can see right through you. Yeah, I may be drunk right now, but here's a whole gimme.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm blessed by the best. I've been astute. I've been resolute. And I've been the one that really, when I was younger, when I was a kid, they said I was supposed to be a prophet, this, that, and the third from way back when. I never believed that shit, man.
Right.
And here's the whole game.
You never believe that.
You can always read scripture now. Because you know what? I can always get you back on your foundation.
All right, now, let's get some scripture.
Man, you know what? I'm right here. Read it.
Proverbs 30,
31. Ooh, actually, today's the first.
Yep.
Proverbs 1, Psalms, the 1st to the 31st. And, matter of fact, Job 31, they go ahead and hit that. Ooh, Daniel 36. Oh,
Daniel, man. I'll go to 12.
I'll get you on scripture. You can't touch me.
You MC Hammer now?
Nope, never had, never will be.
1st Timothy,
you said 31.
Can't touch
this. You said 31?
A blessing.
In three.
I used to be a habitual liar and everything. I used to kill a lot of people.
Oh, fuck.
Because, no, here's the whole gimme. My change came from above.
That's it.
And that's so I can tell everything about all of you. And I had nothing but love. And you don't even know me from Adam, and I know you the.
Let me read the scripture, bro.
I can see.
Proverbs 31 and 4.
Without you seeing me.
It is not for kings, O Lebanon. It is not for the king to drink wine, nor for princes strong drink, lest they drink and forget the law, and pervert the judgment and any of the afflicted. Give strong drink unto him that is ready to perish, and wine those that be of heavy hearts. I mean, you know,
you need it. You need a drink when you're living out of this
place. Understandable.
Suppression makes you drink.
No, but here's the whole thing. But look, I don't overdrink, but I do drink.
Right. We all drink.
I ain't gonna lie. I got a dream of pipe right now.
We all drink.
I drink.
And I'm getting a drink when I leave.
The Lord drank.
I ain't gonna lie.
Right.
I can't lie. I can't lie no more.
Oh, I got a scripture.
Let me finish this one, though. Let him drink and forget his poverty and remember his misery no more. But when that buzz goes down, you wake up with that massive hangover, that poverty and that misery is magnified.
You know what I'm saying? I already know what it says. Just read the word. I know the word. Verbatim.
Open thy mouth for the dumb and the cause of all such as are appointed to destruction.
Hey, can I read Judah's blessing real quick?
There you go, bro.
There you go.
Well, I'm going to read Judah.
There you go.
Go ahead, bring it out.
There you go.
I'll get that if I get Judah's blessing.
There you go.
1 Timothy 5 and 24.
Timothy?
23.
Oh, you went to Timothy on this one.
That's why, Jeff.
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
Drink no longer water, but use a little wine for thy stomach's sake and thine often infirmities.
Yeah, for infirmities.
A little wine.
Too much of that wine, the throat explodes your head.
But here's old Gimme. I'm not over intoxicated, but yet I was still able to bless and give everything back and forth. I still was holding my equation from the blessing that I got. So, how have I fought? Am I not still a man?
We never said you did.
He's saying you can drink.
That's what we're saying.
I already said I've been drinking.
Good for the bones.
I just said I was a belligerent. But I was still able to.
Hey, let me read. Let me read his Genesis right quick.
So, you can't chastise what your understanding hasn't even been astute to be.
It was backing you up, not condemning you. Check this out.
Understandable.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let me read this for you, bro. This is the blessing that Jacob, a.k.a. Israel, a man named Israel, gave to his son, Judah. And Judah is the head tribe of the nation of Israel. Okay? And this,
I already know.
All right.
People from Kenya.
The people from Kenya.
Keep reading.
All right.
Obama's people.
Genesis,
that's where Obama's dad from. Obama, Kenya.
Let me get this on there.
Yeah, original man.
Judah.
Original man.
This is Genesis.
I'm original.
The only original is the Israelites.
And I.
Well, you're an Israelite. Everyone else is a heathen. See, we're Israelites. Genesis 49:9. Judah is a wine's lilt. From the prey, my son, thou art gone up. He stooped down. He crouches a lion. Look, he's stooping down, crouching as a lion. And as an old lion, who shall rouse him up? The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come. And that Shiloh, that Yahweh Shad. Unto him shall the gathering of the people be.
Wow.
Binding his foal unto the vine, and his ass's coat. Peep this out.
I know who I am.
And it's his ass is cold. Listen, can't talk while the scriptures is coming out now. Binding his foal unto the vine and his ass's coat unto the choice vine. He washed his garments in wine and his clothes in the blood of grapes. His eyes shall be red with wine and his teeth white with milk.
Mm.
So Judah, that's one of the characteristics of Judah is that his eyes is red with wine. Just like the Lord was the lion from the tribe of Judah.
I'm original tribe of Judah.
Yeah.
Original. When I say I'm original man, I never lied. And I show before you even read the scripture, to show before. I know who I am. You know who you are?
Yeah, I'm an Israelite. We're the sons of God.
Automatic. You know what? I'm not gonna say. I'm not wiser. I'm not more astute. But here's the whole rest of me.
What you about to get? Bring, come on with that.
Ecclesiastes 3.
No, we got. We're gonna get you.
Solomon.
We're gonna get you.
4:7.
Give me that. Second Ezra, the second chapter.
Wow. You actually think you'll get me back together?
That'd be good for him to hear.
You actually think you're gonna get me back together when I never falter. Actually, I falter every day. Let me not say that. I do falter every day, but at the same time, I'm blessed every day because I give sight to the blind.
We all falter.
85% of this world is dumb, deaf, and blind. I give sight to the blind. And I bless them with the gift of sight so they can ignite and give their grace back for the essence that gave them their presence and gave them this, how they live on this earth. This is the real birth. This is what really, truly means to be. How you want it. You know what? I don't need to hear nothing else. I already been for established. And I can really, you know what? I'll give you quotes all night long. This time, I don't have, but here's the whole game. From what is much is given, much is received. And at the same time, your beliefs need to be.
I got this second.
He's in the spirit.
I got this second.
He ain't talking about no wicked shit. Go ahead.
Second half is 2:42.
Giving praise to the Father.
And I did before I said something.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I took a breath. Hey, I gotta get my effervescence back in order to show my presence. I don't lack on my hope.
They read the scripture, brother.
Second Ezra 2:42.
Does it help you? The scripture is out here to comfort us.
Understand.
I, Ezra, saw upon Mount Zion a great people, whom I could not number, and they all praised the Lord with songs. And in the midst of them there was a young man of a high stature, taller than all the rest, and upon every one of their heads he set crowns and was more exalted, which I marveled at greatly. So I asked the angel and said, Sir, what are these? He answered and said unto me, These be they that have put off the mortal clothing and put on immortal and have confessed the name of the Lord. Now are they crowned and receive songs. Then said I unto the angel, What young person is it that crowneth them and giveth them songs in their hands? So he answered and said unto me, It is the Son of the Most High, whom they have confessed to the world. Then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord.
That's what we do. We standing stiffly for the name of the Lord. We ain't standing, there you go. We ain't out here standing stiffly for the United States of America.
Keto.
Then the angel said unto me, Go thy way and tell my people what manner of things and how great wonders of the Lord thy power thou hast seen.
That's what we do. We talking about those great wonders.
Scripture.
You see, the Lord said he going to put crowns on all our heads. We're going to be kings. That's why they call the Lord the King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Woo.
And soon we're going to rule this earth, bro. We're going to be kings.
Yeah, right.
We're going to be true brothers again.
Yeah, we're going to be true brothers
at the same time.
I
had to bow before the throne because I heard the voice.
Let me get this.
I had to bow.
Let me get this.
And that's why I bow.
Let me get this.
Did you hear?
I feel you, man.
Did you hear?
Yeah.
Did you hear?
I didn't read this.
That's why we out here. We heard the calling.
This is
I'm not the one to be on some bullshit, Mike.
Let
and
me
I mean that.
Out real quick. Ecclesiasticus 36:1. Have mercy upon us, O Lord God of all, and behold us, and send thy fear upon all the nations that seek not after thee.
Right.
Lift up thy hand against the strange nations and let them see thy power.
Mm. Hey, Sean, get that other camera on standby.
Yeah, these heathens, they gonna see the power.
Well done. Man, look here, man.
They hear the power right now.
I know, motherfucker.
They see it, though. They see us on here. They see it. You know? That foundation that they can't, they ain't been running us off this level of campus for years now. There ain't nothing they can throw at us to get us off this level.
You say the Hittites?
is my sworn enemy.
He said it's Canaanite.
Canaanite, that's right. Yeah. Sworn enemy, yeah. That's spiritual too.
That's the entire
Yeah. Y'all be blessed.
Here we go. Hey, one more scripture for you, brother.
Yeah, goddamn. The worst of them all is the Amalekites.
Man,
the Amalekites are the devil.
One more scripture for you. Ecclesiasticus. Ecclesiasticus 41:3. Fear not the sentence of death. Remember them that have been before thee and that come after. For this is the sentence of the Lord over all flesh. That's why we out here, man.
Before my breath and everything that I take for every strength, I've been an ark and I will cut every throat for everything that cut back against everything that's righteous. I'm an ark.
That's actually
understand that.
We all arks too, bro.
Understand that. I'm what? Why you think I'm still kneeling back?
You know what the word ark means? It means the first.
Do you agree that America should be destroyed?
This is the land. This is the land of the first wicked.
Oh, there you go. All right.
The first wicked.
I can accept that.
Your parents set them here first.
I can accept that.
And then, look. They say Columbus here first, but it's named after Mega Vespucio.
There you go.
Mega Vespucio, the Spaniard, they was here to take over the gold and all that shit. They killed them with everything and they took over the older land.
Yeah.
Trust and believe.
How you discover
knowledge born.
Yep.
I'm knowledge born. Born.
So you agree this place
born.
Needs to be destroyed?
I got my sword is heavy in the second place.
Alright, man, we're talking to you, brother.
I mean that.
Alright.
I mean that from the heart.
Just
keep spreading
that truth, bro.
I mean that from the heart. And I always do. Because I can see people before they see themselves.
Yep.
And they be like, God damn, how the fuck you know that? And I just
You can see right through their simple asses.
All the men.
Yeah.
I'm really an art.
Alright now.
I'm not this self-righteous.
To be honest with you, though, he didn't really go off. Did he?
No.
Not really. Think about it. Did he say anything that was really that off?
He was just being obnoxious.
He was obnoxious, but...
That's most black people.
He wasn't blessed yet.
Well, he did say they told him, they was telling him he was going to be a prophet, but he didn't believe that. He said, well, I didn't believe that shit.